Hey folks, welcome to another Triple T Thursday. For those just joining us, that's Tools, Tips, and Talk, where we'll discuss info for the knife maker. In today's episode, I'm going to show you guys a new product. Not sponsor or anything like that, but something I've been meaning to try for a while. And it's this stuff. Okay? So if you heat treat stainless steel, one of the things you can't do is have any kind of oxygen around the stainless as it's heating or anything like that, because it'll just build up oxides and it'll ruin it. So what most people do is put it in this stainless steel foil, and that stainless steel foil is very expensive. So and it's a bit cumbersome, and I'll talk about some issues that I have with it a little later when I show you. So this is a high temp paint that you basically paint your knives with before you put them in the oven, so that you don't have to use the foil. So we're gonna check this out, see how it works on some AEBL stainless, and bring you guys along. Let's go take a look. So here's the Condursal, the Z1100. This is the stuff that goes to 2100. So we're going to be trying this on these knives. So first off, I've got two knives. These are both AEBL. I've got two because I'm going to use one as a control, and we're going to use stainless steel foil, and the other one we're going to put the Condursal on. The reason that the main reason I don't like the stainless steel foil is that it's expensive. It's $100, around $100 for this roll, and it's only 25 feet long. So that's quite pricey. Plus, it's a bit of a pain to fold it. You're guaranteed to cut yourself on this stuff because it's really sharp. And you got to make these pouches like this one. And sometimes I accidentally make these a little too wide and they don't fit in my my quench plates. My quench plates are 4 inches, but there's a couple bolts where the vise holds it in. So that's a pain. Sometimes I like to do two in here like this, and once in a while they'll kind of overlap like that. And then when I press them, it pinches this and wrecks that part of the knife. So there's a bunch of reasons I don't like the foil. I would love to be able to just handle these individually, put them in the plates, be able to see them. So yeah, we're going to try it. So first off, I'm going to surface grind these just to get them all nice and smooth. These have been annealed, and then we're going to coat them with Condursal. All right, I've got these all surface ground. We're going to put one aside. We'll put that one in the foil. This one we're going to put the Condursal on. So this stuff is, it's a paint. I've mixed it well, which is per the instructions. It is pretty noxious, so I suggest you do this in a ventilated area. And they say to put it on pretty thin. So I'm just gonna kind of brush it on. And you do want it even, and you don't want any drips, because if you get some thick areas, the instructions say it can peel up if there's some thick areas. Okay, I don't think I need to do the whole handle, but I'm gonna do it anyway. Alright, so it says it takes 10 minutes to dry, so we're going to check. So here it is, dried up really nicely. There was a couple of drips here, but it's only on the handle, so I'm not going to worry about it. But yeah, let's get it in the oven. I've already done the other one in foil. Let's get them in for heat treat. First up is the one in the stainless steel foil. We'll heat treat that one as normal. Mm-hmm.
I'm also running my water-cooled quench plates. If you want to know how to build these, there's a link up in the corner. They help cool down these plates and the knives much quicker. Now it's time to heat treat the one with the Condursal. I gotta say, it's already much easier getting it into the plates.
So here are the two knives. Obviously, this is the one with the Condursal. So far, so good. Let's open up this one and we'll do a visual compare. So visually, this one's definitely a lot brighter. But yeah, looks don't mean everything. Let's go test them on the HRC tester. So I'm at the HRC tester. I've already made sure it's calibrated, so we're going to test these. First, I'm going to test the foil-wrapped one. Okay, so that one came out at 61.5. It's pretty low, actually, but this is roughly ground, and there could be some decarb on it, so we'll do three tests on each one, exactly the same, and again the same. All right, now we're going to test the knife with the Condursal. All right, it's exactly the same. Oh, see, that one came out at 60. And it's also where we see the discoloration the most. The first one was up here in this silver area. So now we're going to test near the tip. Yeah, 60.5. So what this tells me is there could be a little more decarb on this one. So what we're going to do is we're going to go grind these, surface grind them with a high grit belt equally on each one. We should get to some harder steel, and we're going to see what the hardness is. And I think we're just going to find that this one's probably got more decarb. Okay, so I've done four passes on each one at 320 grit. Now we're going to start with the, again, with the foil wrapped one. Exactly the same. Okay. So these came out basically the same, which is a little surprising. I would expect these to be harder, so something else wrong, but let's check this one. 60.5. Okay, 61.5. Okay, that one's 62.5. So we may still be hitting some decarb. What I'm going to do is temper them, and well, first I'm going to put them in the freezer for a while, then we're going to temper them, and we'll try this again. So after temper on these guys, I thought there might still be a little more decarb, so I ran them through the surface grinder the same number of passes. Then I tested them, and still this one, which is the one with the Condursal, was just a little bit off, so I did maybe two more passes on each side, and then they're both identical. They're both come out right around 59.5 HRC for the blades. So all in all, I think the Condursal gives you just a little bit more decarb on the outside, but it's plenty worth it. This stuff makes it much easier to do the blades. I'm pretty confident. I've actually done a couple more blades as well. I'm pretty confident that this stuff works, so I was pretty happy with it. If you want to get some of this stuff, you got to go to the Duffy Company, and unfortunately you can't order it from their website. You actually have to call them. There isn't a way to order it on their site. I actually talked to Mike Duffy, I think their CEO, and he was really nice and gave me the spec sheet and told me all about it, you know, answered all my questions. So, and they are the only distributor of this stuff in the US. If you're Elsewhere, this stuff actually comes from Germany. So if you're over in the UK, in the EU, it's a lot easier to get than it is in the US. But we do have a distributor now. I paid full price for this. I just wanted to try it. I'm pretty happy with it, and I will continue using it. So, guys, if you want to use an alternative to stainless steel foil, there you go. Thanks, folks. We'll see you on the next one.